Hey guys, I'm really excited for today's video. Today I'm going to show you how I do keyword research.
Welcome to my Golden Keyword series. If you want to learn how to find profitable keywords and other KDP tips, subscribe to my channel.
In this first video, I'm going to show you the keyword research methods my wife and I use that got us to over 80,000 book sales on KDP. So first, I'm going to explain the basic concepts and metrics I look for when searching for a hot niche. And then second, I'm going to go to Amazon's website and show you what I do and how I do it. What do I look for in a good niche? Okay, so there are 6 points that I look at. I'm just going to tell you each of them quickly and then go over each point in more detail. Okay, so the first thing I look at is number of search results, then average bestseller rank or BSR, then average reviews, the average price. I also look at if other books use the same or similar keywords. And then the last thing I take a look for is if there are recently published books on page one. Okay, so let me go over each of them in detail now. So my recommended number of search results would be between 250 and 3,000. Anything below 100 for sure would be not good because it shows it's most likely not relevant to the search term that you're looking for. Or there's just not enough search volume to make it worthwhile your effort to make a new book. The maximum amount of search results I would look for would be 4,000. If you're a beginner, after that, it would start getting too competitive. 4,000 search results might sound like a lot to you, but it's actually not too much. Because out of the 4,000, there's only going to be so many relevant books that you actually have to compete with. A lot of them will be spam or books that are low quality or books that don't actually fit the search term, but Amazon is showing the results anyways. If you go to like page 10 of some search result, you'll see that those books are not actually fully relevant to your search. So out of 4,000, there might only be a few hundred or maybe even less than 100 actual competitors you're competing with. So it's actually not too. So the recommended average bestseller rank for me is anything below 250,000. At 250,000, you're going to get a couple sales a week. So to me, an okay range would be between 100,000 and 150,000. A decent range would be between 50,000 and 100,000. And anything below 50,000, when you find those, you can throw a party. Okay, so just one thing I want to also go over. Just because a niche has a low BSR does not make it bad. And just one example, if you create books for 100 small niches that each only gets 2 sales per week, that will translate into possibly $250 per week or $1,000 per month. That's not too bad, especially if you can just keep doing that and keep doing that. Recently, when we looked at all of our book sales in total, we saw that just under half of all of our book sales are from books that we created in really small niches. So small niches do pay off. I mean, now we've sold over 80,000 books since the last 2 years. So that's quite cool. Okay, so for recommended average reviews, we look for niches that have an average of less than 2,000 reviews. So if a search result has 48 product results on page one, that is only about an average of 40 reviews per book. That is not very competitive, and it will mean there are at least a few books with very little, maybe even if you're lucky, no reviews. Obviously, the lower the average reviews, the better your chances for ranking on page one because there's less competitiveness. And those books are less established, but the lower, the better. The more reviews a book has, the harder it could be to compete against. For example, if a book has 2,000 reviews and you're trying to compete with that book with 0 reviews, your chances of getting sales are quite low. So you want to find niches that have books on the first page with very little reviews, so you have a good chance of competing with those books. And just one thing to keep in mind, the more reviews a book has, obviously good reviews, then the more conversions and sales that book is going to get. So if you have a lot of books on page one with 5 stars and 2,000 5-star reviews, you're going to struggle getting onto that first page until you get a lot of reviews yourself. Unless they're fake reviews, then you could compete against those. Okay, so for average price, we don't like racing to the bottom. We look for niches that have an average price between $7 and $9 or $6.99 to $8.99 for black and white books, because that leaves us enough room to make a good profit and allows us to run a lot of ads, even with high cost per clicks. The lowest we would go for in a niche would be $5.99, but that would be the absolute lowest. And just obviously keep in mind that if a niche has a lot of books at $5.99 or lower with a lot of reviews, you're going to have an even harder time competing against those. Because a book with 1,000 reviews priced really low, almost no profits, there's nothing you can do really to compete against those books. And for us, running ads has been a huge key part to our success, because the ads, when you run them, they will help you rank organically. So it's always good to run ads right at the beginning. Don't wait to run ads after 30 days. Try and run ads right when the book goes live. So if you run ads and get that boost from Amazon, you can really see a lot of benefits on ranking your book on page. And just another tip, don't go so cheap and race to the bottom. A lot of people don't look for the cheapest books. I myself have never searched for the cheapest book for anything. I buy books that are on page one and I don't really care about the price, because anything between $5 and $10 is cheap enough for me. So the other thing to look for when you're looking for a new hot niche on Amazon is the competitors on page one have similar keywords. If not a single product on page one has a similar keyword, that just means that your search term is just not relevant and probably not searched for. But if there are similar keywords, then that's a good sign that people are searching for that and people are competing against that keyword. If a lot of your competitors have similar keywords, but not the exact match keyword that you're typing in, then that can give you a really good advantage in actually ranking for that keyword on page one, since no one is using a keyword besides you. So if you find a niche where people use similar keywords, but not the exact keyword, and you'd be the first one, then that's a great opportunity. So if competitors are using similar keywords, but not exactly the same, that makes your niche that much better, because you'll be the only one targeting that exact keyword, which will give you a bonus and a boost in the rankings. Also, if no one else is using that exact match keyword, it'll also be easier for you to just rank on that on page one for that keyword. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so the last thing we check for is, are there recently published books on page one? If there are recently published books on page one, that shows you that it's possible to rank on page one and it's not too competitive or saturated. If there are no books at all that are recently published on page one, that could be a sign that the niche is saturated and too established, and you might just have a really hard time getting into it. So if there are no recently published books at all, you might want to consider staying away from it, especially if you're new to publishing. Okay, so what departments do you do keyword research in? Well, most customers on Amazon, when they search for any product or any book, they start typing and searching in all departments. So that's where you want to do your keyword research, is in all departments. If you use book departments and do keyword research there, you're going to get different results than in all departments. And the results you're seeing is not what people are looking for. So just make sure you're always searching in all departments, which is where the majority of customers are searching for books. So the only tools we use are the tools I created myself for self-publishing titans. And these two tools are both free to use for anyone.
Hey guys, hope you liked the first video. So tomorrow I'm going to show you how I use my free research tools, how to install them, and exactly the steps I use to find hot niches. So if you're interested in that, subscribe to the channel and see you tomorrow.